Hello friends, in this lecture you will learn about Ziegler-Nichols open loop tuning method for PID controller. These are the contents of this lecture. The learning objectives are steps involved, means open loop, closed loop, and how you will select. Then finding out the reaction rate and lag time. You will determine the various parameters, that is Kp, Ti and Td, and after this, so what is the final response? Okay, so these are the objectives. Adjust and observe tuning method, Ziegler-Nichols tuning method, integral of time and absolute error, open loop tuning method. So these are three main methods of PID tuning, and the Ziegler-Nichols is again classified in two types, closed loop method or oscillation method or ultimate cycle method, and second one, open loop method or process reaction method. Okay. So in this lecture we focus on open loop method or process reaction method. So this Ziegler-Nichols open loop method, it is also referred as a process reaction method. Because during this test, so we set the closed loop system into open loop system, and in this open loop system, just we change the control variable in the step manner. Okay, and for this step change in the control variable, so what is the response or what is the reaction of this process to the change in the control variable output. Okay, so because of that, it is also called as a process reaction method. So this test requires that the response of the system to be recorded on a chart recorder or the XY plotter. Okay, so while carrying out or while conducting this open loop PID tuning method. Okay, so you note down the response on the chart recorder or XY plotter. Okay, and based on this record or curve recorded on the XY plotter. Okay, so we apply the steps. Okay, to find out the constant Kp, Ti and Td. Okay. So the response of the system is recorded preferably by a chart recorder or plotter. You know, steps change, reaction rate and dead time or lag time, these process response values are found. Okay. So from this chart recorder we find out this N, Lt. Okay. And after substituting these values in the Ziegler-Nichols equation, so we get Kp, Ti and Td. Okay, so based on what is the closed loop system, whether it is a proportional or it is a PI or it is a PID action. Okay, so based on that, so we find out these parameters. So first we set this process into open loop system. Okay, so this process variable from the process to the closed loop system, they are removed. Okay, so first we connect the system in open loop method. Okay, then there are some steps that we have to follow for conducting or for tuning this open loop parameters, finding out this open loop parameters. Okay, so first step, we have to bring the process variable to 50%. We have to bring this process variable to 50%. Okay. Now here the control variable versus time and the process variable versus time, these plots are shown. Okay. Here the example of temperature controller is given for the example for finding out this PID parameters or finding out this PID tuning. So here the range of temperature is 100 degree Fahrenheit to 200 degree Fahrenheit. Okay, so minimum is 100 Fahrenheit and maximum is 200 Fahrenheit, that is 0 to 100%. So this is final output of the process, and this is the output of control variable, okay, or the controller. Now what we have to do in the first step, okay, so we have to set this process variable to 50%, okay. So whatever the current process variable value, okay, so that we have to shift to the 50%, okay, or we have to change this value so that it is 50%, you know. So 100 minus 200 means 100 and 50% means 150 degree Fahrenheit. So we have to change this process variable, this temperature, from 140 degree Fahrenheit to 150 degree Fahrenheit. Okay. And for this, the control variable is at 50%. Okay. Now to increase this process variable to 50%, so we have to increase this control variable. Okay. So we increase this control variable in such a manner or in such a way that from 140 degree Fahrenheit it increased to 150. Okay. Now in this case we change this control variable from 50% to 55% so that it reflects change into the process variable from 140 degree Fahrenheit to 150 degree Fahrenheit, or it changed from 40% to 50%. Okay. First, we have to bring this process variable to 50%. Okay. Then, second, step 2, step change the control variable output by 10%. Okay. Now, in this case, after setting this or after bringing this process variable to 50%, okay, here we have to increase this control variable by 10%, okay. Step change means directly from at the instant T1 is equal to, it change from 55 to 65, okay. Step change, okay. There is no linear increase. Okay. So we change this control variable output by 10%. Okay. And this increase is manually. Okay. So it is manually. So you have to shift by 10% manually so that we get the step change response for the control variable. Okay. So to record this on the chart, the time value when the step occurs. Okay. So we have to note down this T1 at what instant we change or we increase the control variable output by 10%. Okay. And we have to observe the process variable response. Okay. So control variable from 55% to 65% is increased at T1. And the final value of the process variable in response to this change is 165 degree Fahrenheit. Okay. So for this 10% step change, the process variable are increased from 150 Fahrenheit to 160 degree Fahrenheit. Okay. So this is the change in the process variable, or it changed from 50% to 60% of its full range at the steady state. Okay. So at T1, the process variable starts changing and there is a steady state response in the process variable. Okay. Now, what we have to do in the next steps. Okay. So this is the process variable response. Okay. and this process variable response is expanded here. And in the next steps, we have to find out the reaction rate, we have to find out the lag time, okay. And for that, we have to draw some lines on the this variable response, process variable response, okay. So, in the third step, we have to find out the reaction rate. In the third step, we have to find out the reaction rate. Okay. So, for finding out this reaction rate, okay, so we have to draw some lines, okay, on this response. Okay. So, first, we have to draw the line, or we have to extend this horizontal line on this process variable, okay, from where the response start increasing. Okay, so initially the response is 50%, so at this 50%, so we draw the line. Okay, so first we have to draw line extension of process variable before step change. You know, before step change, what is the value? Okay, so for that value, we'll draw a parallel line to x axis. Okay, first. Second, we'll draw the tangent. Okay, so we'll draw the tangent to the process variable response to the control variable step change at the steepest rise point on the graph. Okay, so we'll draw this tangent at the steepest point on this process variable response. Okay, so this tangent is required to find out the reaction rate. Okay, so this tangent is required to find out the reaction rate n, okay, of the process variable. Okay? So the reaction rate is equal to the change in the process variable over the change in a time. Change in process variable over change in a time. Okay, change in process variable delta PV, change in a time delta T. Okay, so from this we'll find out the reaction rate. Okay, reaction rate N is equal to delta PV upon delta T. Okay, so for that we'll find out delta PV. Okay, so which is 60% minus 55%, so delta PV is 5%. Delta T is at 25 minus 20 is 5 minutes. Okay, and 5% upon 5 minutes is 1% per minute. Okay, so reaction rate N is 1% per minute. Okay, so in third step, so we construct the horizontal line. Okay, line extension of PV before step change. We draw tangent at the steepest rise in the process variable. Okay. Then, third, from this tangent, we find out the N delta PV upon delta T, that is a reaction rate. Okay. So, at step number 3, we find out the reaction rate. Okay. Then step number 4. So we have to determine, or we have to calculate the lag time LT. We have to calculate the lag time LT. Okay. So this lag time, okay, is find the point at which the tangent, at which the tangent line intersect the extension of original line. Okay, so this point we have to find out, right? So this tangent is intersect at this extension line A. Okay, so this is a point of interaction that we require. Okay, then at what instant we change the step change in the control variable. Okay, so the difference between these two points or subtraction of these two points, so we get the lag time. So we can find out the lag time LT. Okay, so here 15 minutes, here there is a intersection of this horizontal line and horizontal extension line and the tangent, and at 10 minutes, so we apply the step change in the control variable and there is a response for the process variable start increasing. Okay, so this is called as a lag time. So in this case lag time is 5 minutes. Okay, so in the fourth step we have to find out the lag time LT. So in the next step, step number 5, we have to determine the loop tuning constant. Loop tuning constant. In proportional P, we have to find out Kp. If there is a Pi, so we required Kp and Ti. For PID, we required Kp, Ti and T. Okay. So in the fifth step, we have to find out this loop tuning constant. Okay. So for this loop tuning constant, okay, so there are equations find out by this Ziegler-Nicholas for open loop tuning. Okay, for open loop tuning. Okay, and these are the equations. If only proportional type controller is there, then Kp is equal to delta Cv upon Lt multiplied by L. Okay, if controller is PI type, then Kp is equal to 0.9 multiplied by delta Cv upon Lt multiplied by L, lag type multiplied by reaction. Okay, and Ti is equal to 3.33 multiplied by Lt, lag time. And for PID, Kp is equal to 1.2 multiplied by delta Cv divided by Lt multiplied by L. Ti is equal to 2 times Lt and Td is equal to 0.5 Lt. Okay, so these are the equations. Once we carry out all these steps, okay, and once we get the Lt, lag time, and the reaction rate, and after substituting these values of step change in the control variable, lag time and the reaction time in this tuning equation, okay, so we can find out this loop tuning constant. Okay, now in our case the step change is 10%, so delta Cv, so we shift from 55% to 65%. Okay, so that is delta Cv 10%. Then the reaction rate that we find out, N is equal to delta PV upon delta T, 1% per minute, and the lag time is 5 minutes. Okay, so these are the parameters. Now after substituting this delta Cv, Lt and N in the tuning equations, in the tuning equation, so we get the values of loop tuning constant. Okay, so for P type controller, Kp is equal to 10% divided by 5 minutes multiplied by 1% per minute, that is 2. Okay, for PI mode, Kp is equal to 0.9 multiplied by 10% upon 5 minutes multiplied by 1% per minute is equal to 1.8. Ti is equal to 3.33 multiplied by 5 minutes, 16.65 minutes. And for PID, Kp is equal to 2.4, Ti is equal to 10 minutes and Td is equal to 2.5 minutes. Okay, so in this way, first we convert this system into the open loop system, then we bring this process variable to 50%, then we apply the step change in the control variable by 10%. Okay. So why we go for the 50% of process variable? Okay. Because during this tuning, if we change the control variable in the step manner, okay, so there are some oscillations are generated, and because of these oscillations, the process or the mechanical components in the process, they should not get damaged. Okay, so to avoid the damage to the component, to the process, so we bring this process variable to 50%. We bring this process variable to the 50%. Okay, then in the third step we find out the reaction rate. Okay, N is equal to delta PV upon delta T. In the step 4 we find out the lag time LT. Okay, so intersection of tangent with the horizontal line and the instant at which the control variable are increased in the step manner. Okay, and this control variable delta CV, then lag time LT and N, once we get these values are substituted in the tuning equation and we get the loop tuning constant. Okay. So in this way, we find out these tuning parameters by converting this method, closed loop system into the open loop one, we get this parameter. Okay. So what is the objective of this method? Ziegler-Nicholas open loop tuning method. The objective of this tuning constant is to produce a quarter amplitude response in the process variable. Okay. Once we get this value of Kp, Ti and Td, then we set these values into the controller. Okay. And we get the response, quarter amplitude response in the process variable. Okay. So what is mean by quarter amplitude response? Okay. So in open loop system, okay, so these are the oscillations. Okay. Or so it will take a more time to settle down its oscillation, or the system comes to steady state. So it will take longer time. So it will take longer time. And by using this Ziegler-Nicholas open loop tuning method, so we find out this parameter and we set this parameter into the PID controller, and after setting this parameters into the PID controller, this amplitude is died down by the quarter rate. Okay, means say in this first oscillation, the amplitude is from set point, the maximum amplitude is A. Okay, so in the next cycle, so it is a reduced by A by 4. In the next cycle, again it is reduced by A by 16. Okay, so in this way, the oscillations are died down by this quarter amplitude response. Okay, and the system comes to steady state in a very shorter time. Okay, so this is the output of this Ziegler-Nicholas open loop tuning method. Okay, or this is also called as a process reaction method. These are the references used for this lecture. Okay. Now the outcome. So you will be able to describe the various steps. Okay. So after going through this lecture or after listening this lecture, you able to describe or explain the various steps involved in the Ziegler-Nicholas open loop tuning method. Okay. Then from this you can find out the reaction rate, you can find out the lag time. Okay. As there is a step change, so you know the delta CV, and after substituting this delta CV, reaction rate and lag time into the tuning equations, you will get Kp, Ti and Td. Okay, so in this way you can find out these tuning parameters for the closed loop system. Okay. So thank you for patience listening.